So let's talk music, Falana, yes, and ma'am. All things nice.
Yes, ma'am.
Who is Falana? For those that don't know, that are living under a rock, because I have to assume that they've not heard of Falana. They exist on
that. They don't know, they will soon know.
Alright, so tell us.
So, yeah, I'm a singer, songwriter, multi-instrumentalist, and yeah, I feel like that's enough.
Multi-instrument, how many instruments do you play?
I play three. So I play piano, I play guitar, I play drums, like percussion, and I sing and I write my own songs.
I love it.
And if you want to find out more, you can go on social media at Falana Music on Twitter and Instagram. You can find some. I love fashion, I love art.
And I love your hair.
Culture, and yeah, I have crazy hair.
Is it really like, crazy? But it's just your signature hair.
It's my signature hair. People always see me and they're just like, wow, they're so, you know, fascinated. Yeah. But I don't know, I've always been different. Like I told you, my voice has been different. My style of music is also very different. My hair is different. So I feel like it's just a complete package of difference.
Yeah, it's beautiful. She is, I'm still in awe. Okay. So you've been making music for how long?
I released my first project in 2015.
Since 2015.
Yeah. But you know, it's a process of finding sound. Like my sound has evolved. So even like from that project to my EP that I released in 2019 to the album that I'm at now. Because you know me, I don't rush.
Yeah, you take your time.
I take my time because I think that everything is for you.
Yeah.
And I also believe in making music that you play today. If you play one of my songs from 2015, today it still sounds
good. Like I'm about yesterday. To. I'm looking at the song. I'll play it tonight.
So yeah, I'm grateful just for the journey. And I know like next year I'm so excited because I have an album coming out.
Ooh.
And, it's really amazing.
So that your EP, we have discussions. I heard from the grapevine that you self-produced that song.
Yes, I wrote all the songs and I produced.
Okay, well, let's not rush. See,
no rush, babe. Beats. I'm here with you.
Yeah, because if you just give it to us, we'll be in awe.
No,
we might not be able to swallow all Falana. So let's just take it one step at a time. To Bernard by Falana. Okay, yeah. So we'll be back. So I'm not one to hail musician, to hail artists. Sometimes I'm proud of this show. I'm just like, so what's next? So tell us about you. So what is the new music about? But this time I really want to get into Falana's head. What happens from the conception of a track to the production to the release of the track? What's your process like?
So the process actually changed because this song, for example, I wrote. If I tell you the story of this song, to Bernard, there's actually...
Please, we have an hour. Go, go, go.
there's actually a guy named Bernard.
Of course.
Uh-huh. He exists. In fact, he's married now.
Hi, Bernard. How do you feel now?
But yeah, it was just like, you know, sometimes for me, music is about purging. It's about my feelings. Like the song that I released on, I can't remember what, last Friday, was a purging because I felt very helpless. This is TeleTele, what I'm talking about. I felt so helpless, and the only thing that I can do with my hands, is with the gift God has given me, is to write music. So that is just my natural form of expression. It's my outlet. You know, that's why I care about my lyrics and all those kinds of things. And everything else will come into play. Like, you know, we're talking off air about, you know, music has different elements. You have the lyrics. That's amazing. You also have the voice, but the beat is also important. So now, if you now start taking all these elements and put them together, you can jam. When you now listen, you can learn, you can feel something in your spirit, the vocals. So everything comes together, you know. And the process changes because my album that I just am basically finished, almost finishing.
It's done?
Isn't it? You know, I mean, I'm kind of a perfectionist, kind of, not really, but kind of. So it's done until it's not done until it's done.
Yeah,
but
don't bring it out in 2020. We're done with 2020. No. New year,
it's
new
coming,
you.
It's coming.
New album.
But yeah, so we did. Like, I went to Jamaica and I was recording with Dale Virgo. Dizzle, he's an amazing guy. He worked with Drake and Rihanna. He's an amazing producer. Then I worked with Teflon. Teflon got a Grammy for Coffee's EP. He's amazing too. Then I was working with this guy named Lucas in Sweden. He's worked with Akon, Sofia Reyes. Just like, because the thing about music is that you don't even know who will bring what out of you. You know what I mean? So I'm like, this Nigerian babe going to Jamaica trying to like catch a vibe. And these guys, they get me, and you know, we're vibing, and it's just been amazing. Also, someone I really enjoyed working with was Kwame Aboa, who actually worked with, if anyone know, this is like old school, like Cat Stevens and like Pat Thomas. So it's just like a mix of sounds, but then I'm the one that's bringing it all together, you know?
Yeah.
One of the songwriters that I really love, people might not really know her, is Sia. You know Sia.
Sia.
Sia. Like,
hello.
Sia.
If I love your music, do you think I will not love
you, Sia?
Exactly.
So I love the way she like approaches her songwriting, where she it cuts through in the pop space. Like,
yes.
You can feel it. You can jam. You can dance.
Yes.
But if you don't sit down and you listen to the lyrics,
you'd be like,
it will take it to another place.
Chandelier is
chandelier.
Evergreen.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So that's a perfect example of a song. So I love, so that's the kind of thing I feel like is happening. And I don't rush it, but when the time is right, I know, like, everybody loves success. So I'm not, it's not like I'm even chasing, like, obviously I want to be successful. I know that I will. God has given me this gift for a reason.
I like how you just keep referencing God. Go girl, go girl.
No, it's not by my own strength.
Yeah.
It really isn't by my own strength. And even this song, like, like, that's like, I thought I knew God until I had this experience, and now I'm discovering God in a completely different way. That's where the hook came from. Even though I'm writing about something very painful, you know, about something that we experience, this collective history that we now have in Nigeria, you know, it, like, where does it take you to? It takes you to reminding you of who God is, you know, and reflecting on that and asking certain questions that we need to ask, because we all believe. And the song will say, we believe, I believe, we believe, yes, we believe, we have hope in what, you know, we have the capacity to be, you know. So that's why I'm like, my songwriting is just, it is what it is. Sometimes I'm just, you know, expressing myself and hoping that it touches people. And what happens, it touches people, and it will last them, like you said, 10, 15 years. And I have children, and my grandchildren.
And you don't be referencing your song.
And they'll be saying, this is my grandma, see my grandma, she wrote this song.